to the Cooking Hub. I hope you guys are doing perfectly well. Today I bring to you a recipe known as masala appam. Classic appam, everyone has eaten them. But today I bring to you a unique and different style of appam that is served with a specific different masala. It's going to be yummy and delicious. It's going to be mouth-watering, very, very, very yummy. So yes, do you want to learn this recipe? So continue watching this video and let's get started. So to prepare the masala appam, first of all, I'm going to making the appam batter. Now I'm not going to let this batter rest. It's going to be a quick and easy appam batter. I'm taking 3/4 cup of rava or suji. So for the 3/4 cup, just take 1 cup and remove 1/4 cup out of here. So this is 3/4 cup of rava or suji. I'm just using the normal suji. Next in, I'm going to be adding 1 tomato finely chopped. I'm adding in some cumin powder, roasted cumin powder, 1/2 teaspoon of that. I'm adding in 1/2 teaspoon of black pepper for that lovely spice, some salt to taste. Next in, I'm adding in 1/4 teaspoon of garam masala. Now I had kept water for heating. I'm going to allow the water to become hot and then I'm going to be adding water over here. Some freshly chopped coriander for that nice and lovely flavor. Now I'm going to be measuring 1 cup and 1/4 cup of hot water. Remember, for this 3/4 cup of rava or suji, please use 1 + 1/4 cup of hot water. I've added in 1 cup of water gradually and I've mixed this well. Now again, I'm going to add in 1/4 cup of water, hot water, and I'm going to mix it well. Give it a good mix. So in this recipe, I used hot water. So if you're using hot water, you don't have to give this a long rest. If you're using normal water, then you have to give this a rest of 30 minutes. So this is ready. Let me show you guys how it should be thick. This is how the consistency should be, semi-thick, not so thick and not so thin. Now I'm just going to cover this only for 5 minutes, and after 5 minutes I'm going to start preparing the appams. So it has been 5 minutes. Now I'm going to take off the cover. Okay, it has swollen a bit. Let me show you guys now the consistency. It should be thick. That is how the consistency should be. So now I'm going to start preparing the appams out of this. Now, if you wish, you can add carrots, peas, French beans, green capsicums and onions as well, or you can add your favorite vegetables and make it more healthy. As I didn't have much vegetables, I'm keeping it just plain. I'm just adding tomatoes and coriander and that's all. So now I'm going to start preparing the appams. As you know, appam is a very less oily recipe. I'm just going to use only small droplets of oil and prepare this recipe as quick as possible. So let's go to the appam pan. So in the appam pan, I'm going to be adding some droplets of oil. Just one drop in each cavity. That's it. I've added oil. Now I'm going to take a pastry brush and I'm going to lightly give it a nice brushing. Just brush it. This is very important so that our appams don't stick to the appam pan. Although I'm using a non-stick, but this is a very important step that I always do while preparing my appams. So the batter is completely ready. I'm going to give it a quick mix. Mix it nicely. So I'm going to heat this on low flame first.
make sure it's on low flame. I'm taking 1 tablespoon of spoon measurement and I'm going to be adding the batter, only 1 tablespoon in each cavity. So there we go. Make sure you use the measuring spoon, it's a must, so that all the appams are of one size. Now in this recipe I'm not using any baking powder or baking soda or I'm just keeping it nice and healthy, just without the baking soda and the baking powder. So I'm going to be filling in all these cavities similarly. So I've filled in all the appam cavities with the lovely batter. Now on low to medium flame, or you may just say low flame, it's better, I'm going to close the lid and allow this to nicely steam and cook for around 3 minutes. So it has been around 3 minutes and let me check how this is going. Okay, so it's nice time to flip these, so I'm going to flip them just slowly by slowly. Just flip them like this, very slowly and carefully. I've flipped this and I'm going to cook this and steam this again for 3 to 4 minutes. So some appams are ready, completely perfect. I've taken them out in a plate. Similarly, I'm going to prepare rest of the appams. Over here I have a tomato paste. Now in this tomato paste I've added some green chilies, some ginger, some garlic and some salt, and roughly chopped 3 tomatoes that I had chopped, and now I prepared it into a paste. So already the ginger, garlic, chilies and all the flavor is inside this paste. So this is completely ready. So these appams are completely ready. I'm going to keep them aside and then I'm going to prepare a nice tadka. So I'm taking a frying pan. I'm going to heat it on medium flame. I'm adding in 1 tablespoon of oil, 1 teaspoon of cumin seeds, just add it, and 1 teaspoon of rye or mustard seeds. I'm going to allow this mustard seeds and the cumin seeds to crackle just on medium flame. Let them crackle. Adding in some fresh curry leaves. Be careful while adding the curry leaves. Next in, adding in 1/2 teaspoon of hing or asafoetida. There we go, I've added the hing. I'm going to give it a quick mix. This tadka is ready. I'm going to give everything a good mix. The tadka, the curry leaves and everything. I'm just going to mix it nice and well. I'm going to be adding 1 teaspoon of Kashmiri red chili powder, and I'm going to give it a nice mix. Next in, I'm going to add in some salt and some black pepper, 1/2 teaspoon of black pepper powder, and some salt just for taste. I had added a little bit of salt while grinding the tomatoes, so that is how I usually grind my tomatoes, so I don't add additional water while grinding. So I'm going to give this a really good mix. This, simmering it on medium to high flame while continuously mixing it for at least 3 to 4 minutes. So 3 to 4 minutes, keep on mixing. Next in, I'm going to be adding in 1 teaspoon of red chili sauce. Now this is completely optional, but I prefer adding some in this recipe. So if you wish, you can add. So this lovely gravy, the masala lovely gravy is completely ready and done. It's completely nice and thick, just the way I wanted it. So into this, slowly I'm going to be dropping in the appam balls, I mean. Now I'm going to coat them well in the gravy. So just lightly I'm going to toss them in the gravy. I've mixed it. Now on medium flame I'm going to simmer this for 4 to 5 minutes. This has been simmering for some time now and it's completely ready. So you can see the gravy has completely thickened. Now this is completely ready. I'm chopping in some freshly coriander leaves. There we go, I've added the coriander leaves. This recipe is completely ready and let me take you today to my serving table. Let's go. Beautiful and wonderful, easy and quick, simple recipe that is very healthy is completely ready. So masala appam, you can serve this for breakfast, lunch, dinner, or whenever you're feeling hungry and you just want some quick and easy snack, you can prepare this very easy and quickly. So yes, do try this lovely yummy recipe and let me know how it turns out for you guys. Goodbye and see you in my next video. God bless you all.